Let us discuss about the respiratory system of the sepia. Now, when we talk about the respiratory system, you all can see when we have discussed about the mantle cavity. That time I have shown you that there are two leaf-like structure, and that time I told you these are nothing but the gills. So these gills, when you will actually cut open and observe, they look like just feather. And these gills are called as the tinnadia. It is situated into the mantle cavity. You can see one on the either side. They are parallel to the long axis of the trunk. You can see it very well. When we talk about the tinnadium, that means the gills. So they have the central axis, which I have shown into the next diagram. Now this central axis bearing the numerous pair of the lamellae. Now as we all have the alveoli, they have the lamellae. Whenever talk about the gills, their parts are called as the lamellae. So this is the central axis, and these are the lamellae. Now when we talk about the lamellae, so you all can see they become smaller at the tip of the tinnadium. And see, from here till here, you will observe that they are becoming smaller. So because of that only, they give the structure like leaf. And when you will observe the surface of the lamellae, so how they increase each lamellae, when you will zoom it, you will observe that they have the small vessel like structure. So because why it is happening, when we talk about the human alveoli also, we know that it is having the numerous folding in it. So this folding is for the purpose of the increasing the area. Now this the axis, when we talk about, it is attached to the greater part of length, the wall of mantle cavity. Means this, the gills, tinnadium, they are kept in place with the help of the mantle cavity. They are attached. When we talk about the attachment, so it is because of the muscular rod. Now see, when you will observe this mantle cavity, so here they will be having the muscular rod like structure. It is helping for the attachment of the tinnadium. Now when we talk about the what is the role of this tinnadium, their gills, so what they all are going to do, they will aid into the respiration. That means they will make the deoxygenated blood into the oxygenated. So they will have the afferent bronchial vessel. This afferent, when it starts from the E, we know that it is going to bring it. So it will bring the blood to each tinnadium, and this blood will circulate in the complete branches. Means the blood will come from here and it will move in all the part, in all the tinnadium. And this will, this branches will finally collect the blood into the afferent bronchial vessel that will take to the auricle. Now we all are going to discuss about the circulatory system in detail. That time you will understand. And from the auricle, it will be taken out. Now let us discuss about the mechanism of the respiration. Now how this respiration is going to occur, we have little bit discussed. We have learned that the body have the contraction and relaxation. So with each contraction, the blood is taken inside the body, and with each expansion, the blood, I'm sorry, not blood, the water will be taken out. So when the water is coming inside, so what is going to be happen, this current of water will bring the oxygen in it. So this oxygen will be mixes into the blood, which is flowing inside the gills through the afferent bronchial vein, and it will reach the gill lamella through the minute branches. Then thereafter, it will give them the space where the gaseous exchange will happen, and thereafter in the gill lamella, oxygenated blood will be returned through the auricle, and from there the main efferent vein will form. And the union of the minute vessels of the gill lamella, they will take the blood outside. Once again, we will revise the complete respiratory system. We know in the respiratory system, the important role is played by the gills or tinidium, and it is situated inside the mantle cavity. So we have the pair of tinidium, and this pair is having the parallel axis of the trunk, and each tinidium consists of the central axis, which bears the numerous pair of delicate lamellae. And this lamellae becomes small at the tip side, and the surface of lamella is going to be increased with the help of the folding. And this axis is attached to the greater part of its length to the mantle. Now, how it is attached? By the muscular rod, which keeps the tinidium. See, when if it is attached with the muscular part, so what is going to be happen? This tinidium will not move. It will be completely attached into the mantle cavity. Now, an efferent bronchial vessel carries the blood to each tinidium, and this blood will be circulating into the minute branches through the lamellae and collects into the efferent bronchial vessel that will take to the auricle. Okay, so I have written efferent both the places. This is efferent A sanga. Okay, and this is E. Exit E. Okay. Now, when we talk about the mechanism of respiration, we know that when the sepia is contracting its body, water is expelling out. Okay, and when it expands, that means when it wants to take the water inside, it just relaxes its mantle cavity. And when the mantle cavity is relaxed, so that particular time, the mantle cavity cartilage and funnel cartilage, it gets unlocked, and that time the water will be taken inside, and this infundibulum will allow the water to take inside by the palial aperture. So this palial aperture will take the water inside the body cavity of the sepia. And this water, what is the role of the incurrent of the water? First, respiration. Now, this lecture we are discussing about the respiration. So first we said that respiration, then second we have seen that it helps into the cleaning of the mantle cavity, because whatever fecal material and all is there, it is thrown outside the mantle cavity only. Third role of the water is the taking the fertilized gamete outside the female body, and fourth role is into the locomotion, which we had already discussed, that in at the time of the locomotion, it takes the water and exit it from the funnel, and this funnel will throwing or expelling the water with the force, which helps into the jet movement of the sepia. So currently we are talking about the most important role into the respiration. So how the water is coming in? The water is entering in the body of the sepia with the help of the palial aperture. And when the body is relaxed, that particular time only the water is entering. And when the body is contract, that particular time, at the time of the contraction, the this infundibulum wall and mantle cavity wall, they will lock and they will open the funnel, and the funnel is having the flap like structure, which prevents the backflow of the water, and water will be contract. And this exiting water will comprise of the carbon dioxide, fecal material, sometimes ink, and whatever waste part is present. Now let us talk about the respiration. How, what is going to be happen? The blood is entering into the gills through the efferent bronchial vein, and this gill will take the blood which will have the minute branches, and in these minute branches, gaseous exchange will happen, and oxygenated blood will be returned to the auricle, and the main efferent vein will be formed, and this will take the water mixing of the carbon dioxide into the water. That means the gaseous exchange will happen. The blood will receive the oxygen from the water, and the water will receive the dissolved carbon dioxide present into the blood. So this way the respiration will happen. So this is all about the respiration into the sepia. Next we will be discussing about the circulatory system.